I had a thought of building a restaurant review website. So what I thought is that whenever I go to a restaurant, I will write down some thoughts about it and publish it online. So I just opened up Notepad, started an HTML file, published it, went and bought some hosting, and I used a FTP client to upload those files, and I had a site running. So now I was a food blogger. So anytime anyone wanted to see my reviews about a website, they could, a restaurant, they could go to this website and read it. Now the cool thing about this setup is that I only need to make sure that my credit card is still active with the hosting provider. That's all I need to worry about to make sure that my site is up. But then the inevitable feature request came. One visitor of my site, he was like, I also want to contribute a review to your website, okay? So I learned about Node, learned about Postgres, and I implemented a website. Now this website supported login, supported the ability to implement your reviews, but now suddenly the tables have turned. Now I have to manage the database, I have to manage the server, I have to make sure that the website is secure, and like, it's completely my headache now. So what do I do now? So I heard from somebody that build a single page application so that your server load will reduce and most of the rendering of the page is going to happen on the client's browser. So I was like, okay, that also makes sense. So most of the heavy lifting is done on the visitor's browser. Okay, so now my headache has reduced. Now I need not worry about scaling my servers that much because the rendering aspect of it is happening on the client's browser. So now, right now, my setup looks like this. My server is responsible for the HTML, the JS, the CSS, images, API, everything. So again, another friend of mine suggested that why don't you move the JS, CSS, and images to a CDN? So all the assets, I moved it to the CDN, headache reduced. All the images, moved it to the CDN, headache further reduced. So CDN is a content delivery network, and I actually really like CDNs because each time you implement, bring CDN into your tech stack, it completely reduces your headache. So now the only thing that was left was, okay, what do I do with this API and DB that I have? So another friend of mine suggested, so many options are there, why don't you move to them? Okay, that also made sense. So I moved there. Now my headache is down to 40%. But still, my server is still responsible for generating the core HTML, the initial page itself. So still, if my site goes down, if my server goes down, my entire site goes down. What do I do about that? So right now, HTML is my bottleneck. What if I did this? What if I put a CDN on top of my core server itself? And that is what I'm here to talk about, which is we need to change our mindset around the fact that CDNs are only for static assets. What if you used a CDN on top of your main origin server itself? But then the inevitable question comes, what about logged in content? What you can do about that is that you do not need to server-side render your entire page. What you can do is render a logged out version of your page, and then anything dynamic, you could do it on the browser itself. So it's like a hybrid approach. It's neither server-side rendered, it's neither client-side rendered. It's a hybrid approach where half of it is rendered on the server, half of it is in the client. Now the beauty of this setup is that because the CDN is fronting the static logged out version of my website, if my server goes down for 5 minutes, my website is still up because the CDN is always there saving me. And that is how I was able to reach a state of complete nirvana and had no headache left. So that was my small flash talk where I wanted to try to convince you all to think about CDN not just as static servers, like static asset servers, but also beyond that into thinking that you can actually put a CDN on your server itself. Thank you.